The last area we're going to discuss in regards to memory is what's known as long-term potentiation. Long-term potentiation is the strengthening of a synaptic connection that happens when the synapse of one neuron repeatedly fires and excites another neuron. Much of the work on the study of long-term potentiation came from Hebb. Now, you should recall Hebb's law from our lesson on the brain. Neurons that fire together, wire together. Another researcher, Kindell, discovered that even a sea slug was able to create a long-term memory. This was found by how the sea slug reacted to a shock. So what he did was administered a shock to the tail of a sea slug, and the sea slug had a defensive response. When he did this only one time, the defensive posture lasted about 10 minutes. However, if he did this 4 to 5 times in close succession, the sea slug had the same defensive response that lasted for days after the shocks, which shows the sea slug created a long-term memory since its response lasted for days. Kindell quoted that conversion from short to long-term memory storage requires spaced repetition. This goes along with the idea that practice makes perfect, even in snails. So from research such as this, we can see again the importance of neurons firing together and wiring together and the result that changes in our brain and our behavior. Other research by Kindell showed how particular genes getting turned on in the nucleus of a cell can signal neural structures to grow, which is neurogenesis. But this only happens during long-term memory, not during short-term memory. Amazingly, what this means is that every time we learn something that's long-term, it's because our brain has actually changed. So if you remember what we're talking about right now in this lesson, next week, that means that your brain has officially formed new neural connections, which are the basis for your memory of this lesson. So you can officially say that your Udacity psychology class physically changed your brain.